A French kiss is okay, but a guy seems like he doesn't know any other way to kiss. I mean, it's okay at times, but not every single time you kiss. They need to learn something different.
Hi, friends. This is William Kane, and this tape is going to teach you how to kiss. Believe it or not, you're going to see 30 different kisses on this tape. Everything from the upside down kiss, the vacuum kiss, liposuction, and of course, how to French kiss. Well, if you just watch what's on your screen, by the end, you will learn to be a passionate, exciting, romantic kisser. So let's begin.
When you're on a date, you want to stand close together and have fun together, doing things you enjoy. Always try to be kind to your partner. Make plenty of eye contact. When walking together, laugh and tell jokes. Try to walk shoulder to shoulder because this will encourage your partner to think about kissing you. Do things side by side. And notice how this couple is walking so close that their arms and hands accidentally brush against each other. Again, this will make your partner think about kissing you. The closer you are, the better. This is romance.
I like to flirt by flipping my hair. The hair flip works every single time, and then you have the eye contact. And then the best body part to use after that would be the chest, because it's protruding for a reason.
I love it when a girl flirts with me, when she, you know, touches me in a certain way to try to, you know, convince me to do something, or really gives me other signs, like possibly unbuttoning her blouse a little bit here and there, where you can see certain things that you probably shouldn't be taking a look at, or maybe even like a quick smile, but a smile that's like piercing.
This girl's flirtation technique is excellent. Notice how she touches the guy by giving him a playful punch. Then she flips her hair, and finally, she touches him again by bunking her knee against his. Do all of this on a date.
I love it when a girl flirts with me and she laughs at a joke that's really not funny and no one else laughs, but she does. She shows me that she really likes me.
I like to flirt by walking up to him, giving him little kisses on the cheek, or playing with his hair, or, you know, the little playful hitting taps.
A great way to flirt is to stand so close to a guy that he can smell your perfume. Before you know it, he'll be kissing you. Most boys don't know if you want to be kissed. 91% say they have no clue when to kiss a girl. You can usually tell if someone wants to be kissed by how close they sit. If a boy tries to keep his breath fresh, it's a pretty good signal that he wants to kiss.
It's a little bit harder to get boys to kiss you than the average person would think. You have to really let them know that you're interested, paying attention to them, touching their arm or their hand, leaning in very close.
How I get boys to kiss me is, you know, I dress where they'll like it, and I flirt with them a lot. You know, I rub their hair or their face or do something like that. And usually that makes them want to kiss me.
If you want a boy to kiss you, look him deep in the eyes.
I get boys to French kiss me by intensely flirting. I touch his face and I rub up against him. And if there's music going, I dance and try to entice him to do it.
The best way to get close for a first kiss is to do something thoughtful, like adjusting his collar, fixing his hair, something that shows that you're paying attention to him. And then you're pretty much in position.
To get a guy to kiss me, I give him a really, really long look in the eye, and I smile, and I put my head down.
There's something about letting guys see what else is there, like maybe a little bit of a bra strap showing something that you're wearing. They just kind of zero in on that.
It helps to dress in a flirtatious way. But don't overdo it like this girl.
I get my boyfriend to kiss me usually by just touching him and tapping him on the arm or just like rubbing him or just slightly tapping him to get his attention. And it really works when you have a shy partner because sometimes you need to help them open up a little bit.
In order to get boys to kiss me, I flirt with them and I make eye contact and I put lots and lots of perfume on so they come closer and it just attracts them like a magnet.
A lot of girls want to know if wearing lipstick will make boys kiss them, so we ask guys. Most guys don't mind if you wear lipstick. 25% dislike it because of the way it feels. And interestingly, 8% of guys said, yeah, we like it if it has a kind of flavor to it. Most girls dislike stubble, so make sure you shave if you want a girl to kiss you. It also helps if you're funny. Tell jokes. Girls like guys with a sense of humor. Girls also like guys who are taller than they are.
My first kiss was actually when I was 14. I was at the movies, and I'd never kissed a girl before, and I was actually on a date. And when I kissed her, I had so much stuff in my mouth that it ended up being all over her face.
The best way to get close for a first kiss, you know, if you're at a restaurant or whatnot, is definitely distance between you and your partner. You know, if you lean in close, always maintaining the eye contact. It's just a natural tendency. Like, if it's going to happen, the chemistry is there, it just flows. You're close, you're talking, maybe you whisper something, I need to tell you something softly, and then magic happens.
On my first kiss, the boy was a little bit clumsy because he leaned in to kiss me and then he fell, and it was terrible.
When you're walking along, your hands may accidentally brush. You'll stop and turn towards one another. This is the moment you've been waiting for all your life. Lean closer and closer until your lips touch. Keep your mouth closed and breathe through your nose. Then what do? A lot of people say they like to rock their heads back and forth, slowly, gently. Then, to get out of the kiss, playfully fight with your noses.
My first kiss was really bad. I closed my eyes and I puckered up for the kiss, and the guy had his mouth like wide open. So of course when he came in, it was like a baby kiss. It was slobber all over my mouth. It was horrible. And I couldn't help it. I just started laughing. I fell to the ground laughing. And I thought he almost started to cry or something because he ran out of there so fast.
The first kiss is best if it's simple. A lip kiss like this. No tongue involved. For the basic lip kiss, begin by getting your nose on the side of your partner's. Then move forward and gently kiss one of the lips of your partner. Now let's look at it again. Notice here, the boy is kissing the lower lip. Here, the girl is kissing the lower lip. And now she's kissing both lips. For a basic lip kiss, you pucker up a little when you kiss your partner's lips. You can even talk to your partner while kissing, but it's important to make sure your noses go to the side of your partner's nose. The lip kiss is very important because it's like a base from which you can launch other kisses to other parts of the body.
I don't know how I became so interested in kissing. I think when I was growing up, I was orally deprived.
Once I had a shy partner, and every time we kissed, we looked around first to make sure that nobody was there to see us kiss.
Every time she wanted to kiss me, she'd check her right, I'd check my left, make sure no one was looking before we could kiss.
We used to be very shy about kissing in public, so what we had to do was give these little, you know, little quick pecks all over the place, kind of trying to not get caught by anyone around that might be looking at us.
I had a shy partner once, and every time we tried to kiss, we had to make sure nobody was around or nobody was looking. It was great.
You can practice kissing by training your tongue by eating a lollipop and ice cream. After all, kissing involves some of the pleasures of eating in the absence of nourishment.
Well, I practice spy. I make a little mouth, and then I stick my thumb through, and I just run to kiss it.
Yes, you can practice a kiss on your hand. Should you kiss with your eyes open or closed? 67% of people keep their eyes closed in order to concentrate on the feelings of a kiss. But there are reasons to look. For example, one boy said, "I like to look to see where I'm aiming with a kiss and where my lips will hit."
One thing that is a big turn-on is mirrors. I love to look at myself while I'm kissing other people.
My girlfriend enjoys looking at herself in the mirror. And, you know, her concentration is unwavering. You know, when I go over and I'll kiss her neck, and I'll caress her ears.
There's something very exciting about kind of inadvertently positioning myself in front of a mirror and having him kiss me. There's something just horribly sensual about looking at how I look and then looking at how much he's enjoying where he's kissing me.
I like to look in the mirror, and sometimes when I'm kissing my boyfriend, I get so distracted that I just look in the mirror and pay no attention to him at all.
I like it when a girl talks to me when she's kissing me. To hear her kind of give orders when she's doing that, you know, when she's kissing and kind of taking charge, it really makes me feel like a schoolboy again.
If a boy doesn't say anything to me at all when we're kissing, I feel like he doesn't like me or something. It's really depressing.
I like guys to tell me jokes while we're French kissing.
When we're kissing, she doesn't like say a couple words or something sweet, it doesn't seem like she's really interested or wants to be doing it at all.
Where's the mint?
I personally love to talk a little bit here and now while kissing. I think that it really makes a connection.
How's that?
You're standing on my foot.
Try to say something romantic when kissing your partner.
When I laugh, it doesn't mean I'm like laughing at the guy. It tickles and it feels good. I can't help it.
Sometimes while I'm French kissing, I start laughing, but it's not because I'm not enjoying it. It's because I'm having so much fun.
Sometimes when I laugh, I just almost like a little giggle. It just because it feels good, and she always thinks I'm laughing at her, but I'm really not.
It's really a positive sign, and people will mistake it that I'm, you know, that I'm laughing at their kissing style, but really it's just that I'm having such a good time with them.
98% of people occasionally laugh while kissing, and when it feels excruciatingly good, 2% of them even cry.
I like getting kissed on the eyes.
The eye kiss. Sensual, sweet, and so romantic.
A lot of times while I'm kissing, I'll kiss my partner's mouth, and then I'll kind of move up, and I'll kiss one closed eye, and then I'll kiss the other closed eye, and I love for people to do that to me. It's a really great way to show your affection, especially when they're not wearing contact lenses.
The best way to do the eye kiss is go from the mouth to the eye, to the other eye.
I like the boy to nibble on my ear while we're French kissing, but not bite it off or anything, just to nibble on it a little bit.
I really like to bite my partner's ear sometimes while we're kissing. I think that it shows them that I'm turned on and that I'm ready to go a little bit further.
I like it when a girl gives me like a little nip right on the right on my earlobe, just to show me she's interested just as we start to kiss.
I like the biting kisses, you know, when he bites my ear or bites my neck or something like that. It feels really good.
I really, really enjoy kissing ears. You know, it's you start off just by kissing the base of the ear near the lobe or on the top of the ear, and you circle around. But then you have this element of surprise where you're building up tension, and then boom, you actually bite, and it comes to this climax where you really feel you know, just the energy between the two people is as high as it can be.
Begin by kissing the ear romantically, and then playfully give the ear a little gentle love bite.
I like a boy to touch me when he just touches my shoulders and my face, and how he puts his hands through my hair.
It's nice to hug your partner when kissing, but probably the best thing to do is to run your hands up and down your partner's back. Even doctors do this when kissing nurses. Girls love to feel your hands caressing them. What's this girl doing? She's holding her boyfriend's ears gently with her fingertips and tilting his head from side to side. In this way, you can position your partner's head so it's exactly where you want it to be for your kisses. Play with your partner's hair. Yeah, you can even pull it gently. Just like that. But only cup their butt if you know them really well. One of the most common kissing errors is the A-frame stance, where just your lips touch, but your hips are far apart so that your bodies form the letter A, like this. To fix this problem, bring your hips together and put your feet inside your partner's feet. This way, you can get more intimacy and touch your knees and legs together while kissing.
Breaking up and making up is what love is all about.
There's a kiss that, when you think about it, you might say, oh, I never want to experience that kiss. But inevitably you will, and it's the makeup kiss.
We fight, like everybody does, and sometimes it's pretty major. And more often than not, I'm mad, more mad than him, and want to just leave and get away, and he'll follow, which is good. It's another tip. And I'm not really sure that I want to be intimate again right away, because I don't feel like the issue is completely resolved. But there's something to be said about having that makeup kiss and reconnecting and then taking it from there.
You know, we fight just like any other couple. You know, when she gets angry with me, she'll run away from me or walk, you know, with that strength in her walk that she can do just to, even when you know she's angry and she doesn't want to be with you. And then, you know, I try to catch up. I chase, of course. Who wouldn't? But it ends up, you know, when I do finally get her back and I have the opportunity to get her attention, you know, I give her the makeup kiss, which, you know, you're when you do that, you know, you have every intention in your own mind to getting her back on your side.
Kissed on the ear.
It drives me wild.
Drives me crazy. Really turns me on.
I had a talk with my girlfriend not too long ago, and she told me that she really, really enjoys getting kissed in the ears, and I, you know, even more than her mouth. And I was really, really surprised by that. You know, I didn't believe her. But then, as it turns out, I started to kiss her ears, and she went absolutely crazy, berserk, out of her mind. It was awesome.
Guys, here's one secret that no one's probably ever told you, but if you really want to drive your girlfriend crazy, you gotta kiss her on the ears. It drives them wild.
One thing that drives my girlfriend crazy is when I nibble on her earlobe. You know, I just move in, if we're kissing and whatnot, and I move my way up there and use my tongue and sort of caress the back of her ear. And it just starts driving you nuts, you know, almost borderline ticklish, like turned on ticklish.
Women like ear kisses about twice as much as men. But some guys do enjoy getting their ears kissed. The technique is to do it gently and repeatedly, just like this.
I have a little trick when I call my girlfriend. I keep the phone up like this. I'll be like, honey, when I see you, I'm gonna kiss your belly just like this.
I'm on the receiver and, you know, just kind of going. giving her the best kisses I possibly can, and she goes wild. You know, it's fantastic.
Most people love being kissed over the phone, boys as well as girls. Try it. See. The technique is really simple. You just make kissing noises into the receiver.
Kiss you all over it.
Probably, other than being kissed on the lips, my most favorite place to be kissed is on the neck. It almost makes me want to, like, faint. It feels so good.
The neck is one of my favorite places to be kissed. What really turns me on is when someone will start up here, you know, with my ear, and then they'll start to go down a little bit further, and they'll go down and down and down around to the front of my neck.
One of the most surprising things our kissing survey revealed was that of all the places women like to be kissed, their favorite spot, aside from the mouth, happens to be the neck. 96% of women love it, and if you're a guy, this is the most important lesson you can learn from this tape. Kiss her neck.
My girlfriend loves to be kissed on the neck. It's funny, whenever I kiss her on the neck, she goes absolutely crazy. And I never knew, because I don't enjoy getting kissed on the neck as much as she does, but she goes absolutely nuts. And the funny thing is, whenever I kiss her, she basically loses all the energy in her body. And, like, just, you know, ends up being, you know, basically my, it's like the master of my domain. I can do whatever I want when I kiss her on the neck. So whenever I kiss her on the neck, she just sits, you know, it's basically like that. She'll fall down and be at my mercy.
Other than the lips, the spot where you can spend so much time and just drive your girl completely nuts is the neck. I mean, there's just so much space right here. And no matter where you are, around the back, around the front, on the side, and it's just intense, you know. Whether it's just kissing, you involve a little tongue, get a little wet, and it's just incredible. It's almost as good as the ear, but there's just more, you can spend more time than the ear. So it's just one more thing to make a kissing experience, you know, last long and just be beautiful.
I absolutely adore the neck kiss. Like, if a guy kisses my neck, I just melt to the floor. Like, I am gone. And especially if he moves up my neck and onto my ear, there's no turning back after that.
The neck kiss doesn't do anything for me. I don't get turned on. It doesn't make me want to kiss her anymore. If I do it to her, she just starts melting. Her knees just kind of give out, and that's all she does. She can't talk. She doesn't say anything. She gets all about it.
To get to the neck, begin on her mouth, then move to her cheek, then slide down to the neck. She'll get weak in the knees. Whatever you do, don't forget to kiss her neck.
I love the Eskimo kiss. Like, when you take the noses and you rub them together, it makes you all warm inside on cold days, and I love it.
They rub each other, the front of their noses, you know, back and forth and up and down.
We touch noses and rub noses, sometimes gently, sometimes hard.
On a cold day, rub your noses together like the Eskimos. Run your nose along your partner's until it hits their cheek. Fight playfully with your noses without kissing. Smack your lips to the side of your partner's mouth, inhaling their hopefully delicious fragrance. The Eskimo kiss. Rub your feet back and forth on a rug. You can build up 4,000 volts of static electricity in your body. When you kiss, you'll get a harmless shock. The electric kiss is best done by those who are not wearing pacemakers.
I like it when we pass candy. Me and my ex-boyfriend, we used to pass Jolly Ranchers back and forth, and it was really fun. It was kind of actually exciting, and
We do it for, you know, at least 20 minutes, just back and forth.
I like it when kissing, I can stick my tongue in it and just pull a little piece of candy back out.
I love it when I can take something, especially candy, out of my partner's mouth. Just surprise, you know, a surprise kiss, a surprise French kiss, open mouth, and then boom, I've gone and taken her peppermint or whatever the mint is, you know, Andy's candy, be it whatever you want. You know, that's funny, you know. Surprise is the key with that one.
I like to kiss her all over. I like to kiss all up and down her arms and all the way up to her neck and behind her ears and just sliding kisses back and forth, back and forth. It makes her go wild. It really does.
I like when my boyfriend does sliding kisses, you know, kisses right all the way down your arm on both sides or across the neck or just stuff like that. It's really, feels pretty good.
To do a sliding kiss, execute itsy bitsy little kisses along her arm. You can even do sliding kisses on their leg and foot.
I like the sliding kiss when guys, they go up my arm and they just slowly kiss all the way up my arm and around my neck and down my other arm.
You slide, whether it's up the arm of the girl or up from the ankle, all the way up her side, you know, ticklish area right down there, with it, up her back, along her neck, up over her ear, you know. Ah, the sliding kiss can just go forever and take over the whole body as far as I'm concerned.
An intimate kiss can quickly become wet and rather sloppy. Be polite, take a breath every now and then, and swallow your saliva. See this boy taking a quick little break to swallow? Then back to the kissing.
When I kiss my girlfriend, I love to lean her back, like, you know, Hollywood style, you know, like Cary Grant and Katharine Hepburn, you know, those long, romantic, wonderful kisses that last, you know, for days. And, you know, I don't mind that. I think I think, you know, we don't have enough of those long, romantic kisses anymore.
When my boyfriend plants a big Hollywood kiss on me and dips me back, it shows me that he has no embarrassment whatsoever about showing everybody that we're together.
I love when guys take me and they lean me back all the way Hollywood style and kiss me and just take me in their arms.
Guys, be careful you don't break your back when doing this one. But if you do it right and lean her back Hollywood style, she'll never forget you.
Sometimes my girlfriend likes it when I try to act like the bad boy. You know, she likes to be with the bad boy sometimes. So every once in a while, I'll either, you know, wear the sunglasses at night or put the leather coat on, kind of like a Marlon Brando, Streetcar Named Desire kind of thing. And I'll give her the tough image, and she'll be real into it. Yeah, she'll like it a lot.
According to recent studies, 80% of women would actually prefer to be kissed by a bad boy. If your boyfriend is too goody-goody, you may have to train him to act like a bad boy to excite you more. Here we see a girl who actually goes through the trouble of positioning her boyfriend's feet and arms to make him stand in a bad boy pose. It does take some work, but now she's ready for some bad boy kisses. Look at that bad boy. He doesn't even need a kiss. And that's what makes him so exciting. Making out is a fun thing you can do. It involves kissing and cuddling. You can do it in a car or any place romantic. This is one thing you won't learn how to do in school.
One thing we like to do is that when we're kissing, I'll suck on her bottom lip, and then after a little while, she'll move and suck on mine.
Liposuction is totally safe for a girl. No tongue is involved, and she can breathe through the whole kiss. In liposuction, the boy kisses the upper lip, while the girl kisses the lower lip. Then they reverse.
She has me stand perfectly still, like at attention or from lying down. It's, you know, just stiff as a board, and she has free rein of me.
Tell a guy that he has to just stand there. He can't touch you. He has to stand there with his hands by his side and let you do whatever you want.
Spank him, whatever you want. Drive your partner crazy with the teasing kiss. The rules are simple. They have to stand there at attention and take it while you do whatever you want. One girl said, "My boyfriend never got so excited as when I told him he couldn't kiss me back for one full minute."
Butterfly kisses, because, you know, I just rub my eyelashes and blink in his. It's really romantic.
I love the butterfly kiss. You go up to your girlfriend and you rub your eyelashes up against her cheek, you know, back and forth, up and down.
I really like the butterfly kiss because it's really, really romantic. And it's when the guy and the girl take their eyelashes and they just flutter them together like this.
If you're quiet, you can actually hear the romantic fluttering sound the butterfly kiss makes.
I love public displays of affection.
As Shakespeare said, all the world loves a lover. When kissing in public, there's no need to do a French kiss or anything intimate. A quick, light kiss is best. 98% of people surveyed like kissing in public. One of the pleasures of kissing in public is you can be seen by passers-by, and on some level, we all enjoy a little harmless exhibitionism.
I like the music kiss, and it's when you're listening to really, really loud music, and by every beat you kiss, and you flutter your hair out like this, and then you kiss, and you flutter, kiss.
When you're listening to music, and you're kissing, and you kiss, like, on the beat, and every beat you switch your head, side to side, you just kind of go like this and then this way.
Do you like to kiss to music? If you do, try the music kiss. You kiss on the beat, and every time you kiss, you turn your head from side to side.
Sitting down, my boyfriend leans over me, and I look up, and it doesn't look like him at all anymore, and he leans down and he kisses me.
It really, you know, feels like you're kissing someone else.
I like it when I kiss her, and I lean over.
And kiss me kind of upside down.
She was very low, and I leaned in, and it became an upside down kiss. She didn't look the same, and it was also cool because the lips are also upside down, and your noses weren't touching, you know, lined up to bang against each other.
Lean over your girlfriend while she's sitting down or lying down. The upside down kiss. It feels abnormally good.
I really like the vacuum kiss, and it's when my boyfriend sucks all the air out of my lungs. And it makes me feel really deflated.
Sometimes when me and my partner are doing the vacuum kiss, it'll be so intense and he'll just take everything out of me and I'll slide down on my chair and he'll realize that and he'll just kind of like, if you will, inflate me again and I'll just pop right up like it was nothing.
75% of people have never experienced a vacuum kiss, So it's a great way to give your partner a pleasant surprise. Say, when she's driving a tractor, lean down over her and begin to suck the air out of her mouth and lungs. You can actually deflate a girl like this. But remember to blow her back up again. The French kiss involves tongue contact, and there's really no right or wrong way to do it. The key to good French kissing is being sensitive to how your partner is responding. Some French kissing techniques are, you can touch the tip of your tongues, flickering them like a snake. You can gently bite, lick, or suck your partner's tongue. And you can play chase back and forth like this couple.
You have the most control of it too. You know, you can guide the tip of your tongue all around. And so if you're just using the tip, I mean, you can like, you know, I mean, you can do really quick stuff and have fun and just be in and out, and it's highly sensitive, so it's well worth it.
The best technique is light touching with the tip of your tongues in the front of your partner's mouth.
Start tearing out his hair and just nibbling on the lip and the eyelashes.
The most outrageous kissing experience was trying this thing called the Trobriand Island Kiss.
In the South Pacific, they don't really kiss like we do.
In the Trobriand Islands, the natives begin by squatting down and grooming one another. Then they bite and suck each other's lower lip very vigorously. At the height of a kiss, they pull their partner's hair, and finally they nibble on each other's eyelashes. Be careful if you try this one. It's not recommended for a first date.
You can get so tangled up.
Sometimes the stick shift gets in the way. It's very erotic.
Before you start kissing in a car, it's important to try to get in a comfortable position. Then you can kiss for as long as you want. 92% of people enjoy kissing in a car. It's best to do it while the car is parked. Cars are supremely romantic places. Take your time. Get to know your partner. Small, gentle kisses are very good at the start. If you're not comfortable, you can move over into the other seat while kissing. This is an advanced technique and may take a little practice. Of course, you don't want to do this while the car is moving.
Don't fish mouth when you kiss. You're not trying to swallow the girl whole, you know. You don't want to just, like, fucking cover her mouth.
Don't push your tongue too far into your girlfriend's mouth.
Now what you want to do is play chase back and forth, out, back. But don't go too far back, or you'll make your partner gag.
Some people think that braces are negative. They're actually a positive, because once this guy walked up to me and he asked me if he could try kissing me just to see what it feels like. And it's kind of like when people have tongue rings, and it just feels even better than without braces. So it's a really big turn on.
A hickey is a red or blue mark produced by sucking the skin.
You cannot get rid of a hickey using vinegar or a cold spoon. You have to let it heal by itself. Let me demonstrate how to give a hickey by sucking and kissing Bridget Fontaine's arm.
You can give a hickey by sucking and kissing a person's arm or neck. But remember, it's going to take about a week for the hickey to go away.
We'll be right back. have actually practiced French kissing on a stuffed animal before.
And did it work?
Hi, friends. This is William Kane, and this tape, believe it or not, is going to teach you how to French kiss. Yes, simply by sitting back at home and watching what's on your screen, you will learn how to use your tongue and be a passionate, exciting, romantic kisser. So let's begin.
A French kiss is something I don't get very often. It's a very nice way of showing your affection to somebody, grabbing hold of them, opening your mouth, and really having a passionate, it's more of a passionate kiss than just a small little peck.
A lot of young people are curious about the French kiss. They want to know what it is and how you do it. They ask me questions like, do you really need to use your tongue during a French kiss? Well, of course the answer is yes. Let me demonstrate how you do a French kiss on my able assistant, Bridget Fontaine.
People, wait for me!
A French kiss is heaven on earth.
A French kiss is when you're kissing someone and you use your tongue.
To me, a French kiss is one of the best ways to get to know somebody. It's very intimate, very personality-driven.
Well, a French kiss is when you touch tongues with your kissing partner, and there are a lot of different ways to do it, but when I'm on a first date, I like to imagine what the person's tongue feels like. I like to think about what it would feel like inside my mouth.
Folks, here are some step-by-step instructions for a French kiss. Number one, begin with a regular lip kiss. Number two, you open your mouth slightly while doing the kiss. And three, you move your tongue forward into your partner's mouth. Now, because it's difficult to show the inside of a mouth, I am personally going to go inside a mouth and show you exactly how the tongues move.
Oh!
Yeah. Now, after you touch tongues, your next step is to move your tongues around, and you can play. And a good thing to do is to go around and around and around in a rotating motion. So then now, you knock your partner's tongue around, you go. And you playfully with your partner's tongue. You play with your partner's tongue. You play. You try to have fun with your partner's tongue. You try to enjoy it, and you try to enjoy the inside of their mouth. All the fun you can have in a rotating motion, and that's that thing. You try to get a rotating motion going, and that's basically how to do a French kiss.
You need to stop using your tongue like it's a dart. You don't go like this with your tongue.
One time I was kissing this guy and he was like a machine, or like a lizard, just like tongue darting in and out of my mouth. It was awful. I've had someone just act way too mechanical with me, just ramming the tongue back and forth, back and forth. It was like a robot.
I had this one time where she was way too, what's the word I'm looking for? Mechanical. She would be like trying to stick her tongue in like that, and it just wasn't, you can't do it that way.
You don't want to use your tongue as a dart because, it will hurt your partner, and it's difficult for them to breathe, and it hurts them. It actually, it's like a fighting motion. No, you want to be gentle. Yeah, and because if you hit them like this, you can actually, ow, it hurts, ow.
My girlfriend dumped me.
Why?
Well, she told me I was kissing her too much. French kissing her too much.
I know exactly what you need. You need the art of kissing. Did you know there's more than 30 different types of kisses you can give someone? There's,
really?
Yeah. There's vacuum kiss, there's liposuction, there's even upside down kiss.
Upside down?
Yeah.
Wow. Thanks, Doc.
Well, during this one date, there was the guy who, I guess he was just a little bit over-aggressive, and he stuck his tongue so far down my throat that I couldn't breathe, and I actually had to push him away because it just got so out of control.
Well, when we French kissed, I don't know what happened, but he stuck his tongue way too far down in my throat the first time because I started turning blue. I thought I was going to die or something, and I almost had to get taken to the hospital. It was pretty bad. Annie, oh my God, did you hear what happened to Susie?
What happened?
She got rushed to the hospital because she got traumatized from French kissing.
What happened? Are you kidding me?
I'm not sure. All I know is that she got rushed to the hospital in an ambulance, and I had to give her oxygen and everything.
She's turning blue, doctor.
Get her inside quick. She's having trouble breathing.
Doctor, why is she turning blue?
I've never seen a case like this before.
What happened to her?
Frankie was making out with me. He gave me a very long French kiss. I must have fainted, and they called the ambulance.
Let's get her down to the x-ray lab right away.
You're going to be all right, Sally. I still can't breathe.
These x-rays will tell us if that French kiss did any permanent damage.
Or will I ever be able to French kiss again?
Only time will tell, Sally. Only time will tell.
Sally was brought to see Dr. Ronnie Honeycutt because of complications that developed after a serious French kiss from her boyfriend.
Recently, I was rushed to the hospital due to complications from a bad French kiss. I learned my lesson. You can really improve your French kissing technique by learning to breathe through your nose. I've been through a lot of rehabilitation, and things are much better now. My doctor was an expert in the area, and he taught me how to do it perfectly.
You taught her?
Yes, I did. At first, it was kind of difficult, but then she got the hang of it, and she learned to breathe through her nose during the kiss.
Once when I was French kissing a boy, I could not breathe, and I was gagging. And afterwards, I couldn't talk anymore for like 4 hours, and it was terrible.
The problem is you don't want to make your partner gag. Now, I'm going to show you, friends, where you should stop when you're playing chase or playing with the tongue. You see this tongue on the top, how it's trying to excite the tongue on the bottom by moving all the way back like this? Well, friends, get out, tongue, get out, you're too much. You tell your tongue, get out, get that tongue out a little. You don't want to put your tongue over here, because it'll make them gag. If you go this far back on the tongue, this person was going to start to throw up and gag. And so therefore, you don't want to go bam, bam, bam like that, because you will make your partner gag. Instead, stay in the front. There's nothing in the back that you need anyway. And play. Go, like, play with your partner. But remember, not too far in the back. Yes, that's be a nice tongue. Yeah, there you go. Up in the front of the mouth, and that's the way you'll please your partner.
I've had a French kiss where it's just way too sloppy.
Sloppy kisses are probably worse than gagging kisses. Once you get into it, you think everything is going really nice. If you hear the sucking and the sloppiness and the saliva everywhere, you're doing it wrong.
A lot of people are too sloppy when they kiss. The proper thing to do is to swallow your own saliva.
And you can have towels on hand to deal with the situation.
Once my friend Annie was over, and we were trying to find out what it was like to kiss, and so I suggested that she practice on my uncle, and we snuck into his bedroom because I thought that he was a really sound sleeper. But when we went in there, she kissed him and then did it a second time, and he opened his eyes, and we were like totally petrified. We went running out of the room almost screaming. We were so scared.
Well, I personally like to kiss grapefruits. They're the perfect fruit to kiss to practice French kisses, and they taste good too.
You can actually practice a French kiss on your hand. It's safer, and it can actually be more fun. Let me demonstrate. You may take your hand and you form it like a mouth. And then you stick the thumb through the hand and treat it like a tongue. And you begin to kiss. It's much safer and could be a lot more fun than kissing a boy.
What are you doing?
I practice French kissing more in my mind than physically. I just try to envision really passionate scenes in my head, and that's the way I always envision a French kiss.
When I practice a French kiss, I do it mentally. I pretend I'm kissing like Ryan Phillippe or some like really hot person. I mean, geez, what the heck?
Well, I like to kind of imagine myself French kissing my aunt, if you will. Kind of like in a motherly fashion, you know, taking care of me, showing me, leading me, you know, just kind of walking me through it, if you will. Just a real nice mental picture of me making out with my aunt.
A lot of times I'll do it in my head. I'll pick, you know, if I'm watching a movie or something with a friend, I'll pick an actor or more likely an actress, and I'll try to imagine what it would be like to kiss them in, you know, whatever scene they're acting in.
I usually practice a French kiss mentally. This one time I was at my dentist and my dentist is like such a hottie. And you know, I went under the gas and I just started to have these fantasies about French kissing my dentist. To me, a French kiss is complete oral satisfaction.
French kissing feels great because it's like taking it's like skinny dipping in chocolate, if you will, or Skittles or something like that. It's like a full body motion and intense feeling.
A French kiss feels like you're slowly just melting into each other.
A French kiss is just bliss because it makes you feel like you're so together.
French kiss feels good. It kind of makes you feel like a babyish, sort of.
The nature of French kissing is it's a regression to the oral level. In fact, lovers often regress to the babyish level. That's why they call each other baby. Baby. Baby.
Baby.
A French kiss feels good, kind of because it gives you a lot of attention. There's a lot of personal attention in it. It almost like a baby. You know, if you have a baby who just gets so much attention and fondled in so many ways, and everybody wants to carry and hold the baby and hug the baby and kiss the baby. That's pretty much, I mean, that's kind of how it makes you feel sometimes.
I love to touch the tip of my tongue to the tip of my girlfriend's tongue. The feeling just gives me goosebumps all over.
I'm now illustrating how the tip of the tongues can play. You want to touch just the tippy tip of the tongues, like this. And the tip of the tongue is the most sensitive part. It can taste sweetness, and you want to taste the sweetness of your partner's tongue. You can explore the tip of their tongue. You don't have to go very far in the mouth. You just explore the tip of your tongues. Now watch how the tongues play with each other. The tip is so sensitive, my friends. There are more nerve endings in the tip of the tongue than in any other part of the body. It feels, what can I say, blissful to touch the tip of your tongue.
When I do a French kiss right, and when he does it right, it just feels like we're melting into one person. It's so intense, and afterwards you have just such a great feeling, like, wow.
How do you get boys to French kiss you? What could you do?
Usually when I want a guy to French kiss me, I flirt with him, touch him a little bit.
Getting boys to French kiss you comes in a few different steps. Flirting entails making eye contact and letting them know that you're interested. But they also don't always get the hint about exactly what you want after that, and they might be a little shy, and so it helps to keep your mouth open or lick your lips, get the image of what you're trying to get across into their minds. Be very demonstrative with your mouth, whether it's like getting some kind of food off of your hands, anything. They need a lot of examples.
I find that when I'm going on a date, it helps to wear something that's a little bit trendy and fashionable.
I find that it attracts people.
Okay, so tell me what you think. But Johnny won't French kiss me. He doesn't French kiss me. And at first I thought, okay, maybe it's me. Maybe there's something wrong with me. But like now I'm thinking, no, it's him.
He needs to be more orally conscious.
What?
I'm serious. You need to be able to train him to think about different ways to use his mouth. Gum, one of the best things that you can give him. Gum, he starts, you don't just chew gum. You play around with it in your mouth. Or sucky candy. You give him candy that he can suck on. It works, trust me. He's just not thinking about different ways to use his mouth.
Yeah, I'll try. I'm going to see him tonight, so maybe I'll just like start slipping him the candy.
Yeah.
Here's some candy for you.
Thanks.
You said that you like candy, right?
Yeah.
Well, maybe you'll just finish eating all this candy. It's really actually yummy. I know how much you like candy, so I went out and bought some candy for you.
What's it for?
Well, maybe after you're done eating it, your tongue will be trained so you actually use it.
I usually try to get a guy to French kiss me if I'm really kind of in the mood. I usually get up close to him, you know, kind of put my body next to his, sometimes try to do a little bit of like an arm stroke kind of thing, and at least give him that tingling sensation, kind of let him know that I want to.
How come you don't ever French kiss me?
I just don't.
Why not?
Well, I'm a little shy.
How come?
Well, when I was little, my dad used to beat me with the broom.
Aww.
I don't like brooms anymore.
Poor B.
Just hit me.
It'll be okay.
Rat.
You can still French kiss me, though. I'll show you how.
Sometimes when I want a guy to French kiss me, I look them straight in the eye, and I hold the look longer than it takes. And it just kind of draws them to me.
Usually, when I'm kissing a guy and I don't want to kiss him anymore, I get him to stop by either biting him or pushing him away.
Okay, I'm having this problem with Pete, and it's disgusting. He French kisses me all the time. Totally inappropriately, in inappropriate places. Every single time, if I just want to have a nice little kiss, just while we're driving, anything.
Well, I'll tell you what you need to do.
Please.
It works for me all the time. Bite his tongue. I'll tell you, his tongue will be no match for your teeth. I'm telling you now.
Oh, well, if a guy or a girl is overdoing it, while we're kissing, I'll bite the tip of their tongue a little bit, or I'll pull back and sort of push them away and kind of look to the side, or I'll look at my watch, you know, kind of to let them know that enough is enough.
When I want a boy to stop French kissing me, I usually just bite his tongue because it's kind of annoying with it being in my mouth when I don't want it to be.
My tongue, that hurt.
Playfully, my friends, you can bite your partner's tongue. With your teeth, you take your teeth and you bite into the tongue. You can bite at the tip, or you can bite a little further back. You can bite really far into the middle. Into the middle. And bite your partner's tongue. It feels good. You bite it. Bite into the tongue.
The way to get a girl to French kiss you is to begin by building up a relationship with her on a few dates.
When I like a person and we're on a date and our feet accidentally touch against, you know, underneath the table, it really, it sends waves through your body, you know, it's really very, very, a very unbelievable feeling, and especially when the relationship is new, you really get that That tingly feeling where you feel, you know, this energy, you know, this wonderful energy going through you, and it's so new.
I like to flirt by just staying close, keep arms around her, just keep a conversation going, tickle her, just something, make jokes, get her to laugh, get her to know you, show a little interest. You know, French kiss me.
I just don't like it.
Why?
I got suffocated once.
Come on, it's easy. Just put your hand in the mouth.
Okay.
Make like a mouth. Now put your other thumb through it just like a tongue.
Okay.
And like that. See, I'll show you. It's easy.
Okay.
That's too much tongue. Oh,
I'm sorry.
The way I French kiss is I have my mouth open slightly and I don't put my tongue in too far.
While French kissing, I like just touch the very tip of the tongue and then just kind of flick her just a little bit just so she feels it.
I like to, with my tongue, I like to, I gotta go in and I roll around and I pull out kind of like a little game of tag, if you will. Then I like to kind of tickle her tongue and bite it and suck it.
Usually I move my tongue like around the other person's tongue or lick their lips. During a kiss, I kind of like to rub my tongue a little bit along my partner's to get a little bit of a vibration.
French kissing, when you have the tongues, I like, you know, if I know it's going to be a decent amount of time, which there's nothing better than a really long French kiss, is just to start out with, you know, the light contact, almost like teasing. You know, it's right there, you hang in the balance, and then it's just like the floodgates open. Then it's like, then you sneak in and go, and then the longer it goes, I love starting to play the game of like, you know, I got you, you gotta get me, I'm going around here, I'm hiding, you know, so, and then it involves the rest of the mouth, you know, like slide your tongue along the roof, you know, and get them, or underneath their tongue, really sensitive under there.
So I like, personally, I like to take the tongue and just suck it into my mouth. A little bit of power there, you know? Just to show, hey, I'm the boss.
With my tongue, I usually like to just gently feel his tongue a little bit, but very gently, because it's not something that I don't like to have his tongue completely in my mouth or my tongue completely in his mouth. Just very gentle, touching each other's tongues, kind of rolling a little bit. That's about it, yeah. Sometimes I like to just have our lips so that they're almost like biting each other. That can be kind of a nice way to do it too.
What I like about licking her tongue, about touching her tongue, is that intimacy. You know, that feeling that, you know, you two are together and you're really feeling everything that each of you has. And that feeling goes such a long way. You know, it's so rudimentary, but it's so special.
French kisses should start out slow, with the tongues lightly touching each other. But after that, when you start to really get into it, and you get the hands moving and everything else, it's great to suck the tongue and to bite and to really get into it. I mean, the more activity there is, the hotter it is.
During French kiss, I bite my partner's tongue just a little bit, just so she feels it, and then I quickly remove my teeth and suck on it just so it doesn't hurt anymore.
I like to French kiss by spelling my name out with my tongue. Me and my friends came up with it, and sometimes we try to do the alphabet with our tongue, so it's kind of fun.
My boyfriend and I kind of like to play chase, where we chase each other's tongues around a little bit, kind of like a game, move the tongues around each other, kind of dancing.
With my tongue, I like to kind of put it back and forth between our mouths because it's kind of like chasing the tongues, and I feel like I never want it to stop.
What you do is you vary the tongue action. You go slow, fast, hard, soft. You have to play chase with the tongue. You know what I mean, Bridget?
You play chase with your partner's tongue, and this tongue will come forward, and it'll bunk into this tongue like this.
and this tongue will go forward, and it'll hit this tongue like this. And then the tongues will go up and down, in a flickering motion. Flicker, flicker, flicker your tongue on your partner's tongue. That is good. Now we're going to show you how to play chase by pushing your partner's tongue. With this tongue, we'll push while this one will retract. And then, now you come forward on the left here, and you push this tongue out.
One trick that I do when I French kiss is I steal my boyfriend's candies out of his mouth, and they taste better that way.
When we kiss, I think it's a lot of fun when you, like, pass candy back and forth, you know, when I take it from him and everything. But my guy, he just does not like that. He ends up taking the candy from me, and it's not supposed to work like that.
I love it when my partner passes a piece of candy from her mouth to mine. It's just not only getting the flavor of the candy, but getting the flavor of her.
One trick you can do while French kissing is to steal the candy out of your partner's mouth. Notice this girl is having trouble getting it. That's because you're not supposed to let your partner get it. Make it difficult for them. Tease them. You've got to fight for your right to that candy.
A trick that's kind of funny when you're French kissing somebody is, I mean, this is only for more somebody that you're a little closer to. You wouldn't want to do this to a complete stranger. But if they're not expecting it, you can kind of just blow a big gust of air in their mouth and their cheeks blow like a chipmunk. It's really funny.
I remember the first time I got vacuum kissed, it was weird. All the air just got sucked out of my mouth and my lungs, and I felt like I was like deflating or something.
One trick that I'll use during French kissing is I like to kind of suck the air out of my partner a little bit. That hopefully, you know, it feels good when people do that to me, so that's something that I like to try.
Another great trick is the vacuum kiss. You suck the air out of your partner's mouth and lungs. You can actually deflate them. Look, she's getting deflated. Now he's blowing in and he's inflating her. You treat your partner like a rubber doll. The vacuum kiss.
Well, I like a boy to take his hands and go all over my back like this.
Usually when I'm French kissing someone, I like them to move their hands all over my body, playing with my hair, touching the back of my neck, my arms.
Kissing and French kissing is best done like multitasking. Kissing is one art, and the hands are a very necessary part to pull it off. I really like a guy to move his hands up my arm. The softer and the slower, the better.
During a French kiss, I like it when she caresses my face kind of a little like this, or she goes up like this and she starts pulling down tight right before it starts to hurt.
Well, I like to I like for her to start off kind of gentle, but then I like to get aggressive. I want her to pull me in and kind of squeeze my butt real nice.
When I'm being French kissed, I usually like to have my arm stroked. That's my favorite type of action somebody could do for me, or stroke my back a little bit. Just anything gentle that kind of gives me like a little tingling sensation, or pushing my hair back out of the way, out of my face, makes me feel like he wants to see my face.
Well, when I'm kissing a person, I really love them to use their hands. There are a couple of really sensitive parts. You know, if they touch right here, that's really a turn on. My neck and my ears are also super, super sensitive. One other thing is, you know, right here, you know, right above my butt is a really super sensitive part. And, you know, if they can squeeze me really hard, almost like a corset, when we're French kissing, that's really great.
I like her to pull my hair because it shows that she's really excited about what's going on.
When I snuggle with my boyfriend, I like to pull him close and just hold him in my arms and kiss him.
Usually, I like to actually sit on the guy's lap while I'm kissing him, you know, cuddling that way.
I really like to get into the person. Sometimes I'll, if we're snuggling, you know, on a couch or something like this, I really like to put my legs around them. I like to kind of get up real close like this a lot of the time. I love to put my arms around them like this and get, you know, as close as I can.
I love French kissing in the car because people can watch you while you're doing it, and I like when people watch me.
Cars are very intimate places, and it's one of those opportunities where you get to sit right next to each other as opposed to a movie theater or a classroom or wherever else you might get to sit by each other. And so it's great to be pressed right up next to. And there doesn't have to be a whole lot of touching or moving around involved, but just the pressure of having the area from your knee up to your hip, up against your boyfriend like that, it's very exciting.
When we kiss in a car, our position is, like, really tricky sometimes. Like, we'll end up hitting against the steering wheel. Sometimes we'll end up, like, somehow sitting on the steering wheel. And then, you know, like, his butt will sometimes be, like, rubbed up against the window. And, you know, it's really tricky. We kind of, like, almost turn upside down.
You really do have to be careful when you're French kissing in a car. Sometimes a couple will get in such a convoluted position when they're French kissing that the guy will actually fall out the window.
A French kiss should last until I can't breathe anymore.
On a first date, a French kiss should never last more than 60 seconds.
What about our first date? We French kissed for longer than 2 minutes, I think.
I have never French kissed Dr. Honeycutt.
I think a good French kiss should last about 3 or 4 minutes.
A good French kiss shouldn't be too long. It shouldn't drag out. It should be about 4 or 5 minutes.
A French kiss should last however long it's going good. I mean, the minute it gets intense, maybe you want to carry it on for a little longer. If it gets sloppy, then you just want to kind of cut it out a little bit. But I would say average about 3-4 minutes.
Yeah, I think it should last for at least 4 to 5 minutes or until she passes out.
A French kiss should last anywhere from a minute to 10 minutes if it's a really intense makeout session.
French kiss should last, well, hopefully as long as possible. Now, you know, it depends on the situation. In public, you know, you can sneak in a quick French kiss. Like, almost like, did their tongues just touch? No. You know, so quick. But then you can, you know, if it's just the two of you, it can seem like go on forever.
Another time I was French kissing somebody, and this was all my fault. I was getting so excited and into it, and all of a sudden I realized I was getting a little bit lightheaded, and I panicked and couldn't figure out what exactly it was I was doing wrong. And again, I didn't want to say anything, but I felt like I was just going to pass out. I could feel my skin turning, you know, blue, or the red, you know, all the blood rushing to my face, and I'd forgotten to breathe through my nose.
Of course, the proper way to kiss is kissing by not breathing through your mouth. You must breathe through your nose. I don't understand why anybody would want to breathe through their mouth when they're kissing. Let me demonstrate on my able assistant, Bridget Fontaine.
No. Well, I think that usually a French kiss should last about, depending, if you know the person really well, it should last about 4 to 5 minutes. If you're just meeting them, a kind of a fleeting kiss at first is a little bit better. Just, you know, with a little bit of the tongue. But once you get involved in a relationship, it's great if you can get really, really into it and kind of roll around. And so I like to get more into it, you know, get a little bit more length once I know the person better.
You know, a lot of people wonder, when I'm French kissing, what is my partner thinking? Well, we developed an alpha brainwave reader, which allows us to hear the actual thoughts of two people while they're French kissing. Let's listen in.
Oh,
feels so good.
He's so heavenly.
I love her.
I need him.
I want her.
I want him.
God save me.
I'm so crazy for him.
I'm mad about her.
I love his mouth, his
tongue,
his teeth,
her lips,
his arms,
her body.
Oh, God.
Damn.
God, I've never been kissed so long.
I wonder when she's going to stop.
I can hardly breathe.
It's suffocating.
I'm not going to stop first. She'll think I don't like him.
I've got to keep this kiss going.
There's no turning back now that I've started.
I'm in for the long haul.
I hope he gets tired soon.
When is she ever going to quit?
This is getting ridiculous.
I have work to do. Give me a break,
honey. Let's knock it off already.
I wonder what I'm gonna make for dinner.
I need some groceries.
I have to be getting home soon. When is it going
to end? I better break this off.
I've gotta call it quits.
If I stop,
she'll never forgive me if I do.
please, please stop.
Let up, will you?
I'm begging you to stop.
I wish he'd break off.
Leave me alone.
Let me be. God, he's so darn into it. I'm getting asphyxiated.
God, help me.
Please,
I'm begging you, help
me. Please.
We're now going to give you advice from boys and girls about what they wish their partners would do. Friends, if you listen to this part of the tape over and over with an open mind and take these suggestions seriously, your partners will say, how did you learn to kiss like that?
What I would hope that girls would do is just open their mouths just a little bit more so they can be more of a part of the French kiss. You know, not just a receiver, but a giver as well.
One thing I wish girls would do when they're French kissing is open their mouth a little bit more and get a little more active into the kiss. It'd make it a lot better.
I wish the guys of America would take things a little bit slower. I know there's something very erotic about sticking tongues in people's mouths, but it's nice to start out a little bit slower and then work into it before you get into all of the heavy-duty stuff.
Just some advice for the boys. It's nice when you kiss and you're actually able to breathe. You didn't lose anything down my throat. You don't need to fish for anything down my throat. So enable me to breathe and your kiss will last a lot longer. I wish boys would just be more gentle and go slower when they French kiss. And on top of that, maybe not slobber as much.
I wish guys would realize that there's nothing back here that they need to get to. The kissing and all of the interesting areas are more up front and in the roof of the mouth and in the lips, and you don't need to gag your date in order to get something out of the French kiss.
Irish boys would once in a while like let me lead, you know, just because they're guys doesn't mean they have to be in control all the time. Like, I'm not saying I'm gonna like get a whip or anything, but just let me lead once in a while, you know, make it more interesting.
One thing I would really like to see would be more French kisses from girls and use their tongue more, because they tend not to. They really shy and they keep it back. But I'd really like it if they just came out and just gave more French kisses.
I just wish that girls would use their tongues more. I wish girls would be more aggressive with their, you know, with their tongues, you know? Like really being forceful with it, you know, moving it around in certain ways, really so we feel it. You know, so we can feel that tongue there. It feels good.
If you're still having problems with your French kisses after watching this tape, try therapy. There are some good therapists out there.
Doc, I have a problem. You see, I'm afraid of French kissing.
Why?
Because I was French kissing this guy one time, and I almost suffocated. I turned blue and everything. It was horrible.
Oh, my goodness. Well, I have this new therapy. It's called kissing and cuddling.
Favorite tricks that I use during kissing is once in a while I can get the guy to dress up in a blonde wig.
I like to put a wig on the boy and just pretend it's a girl. It's more intense.
Well, you might get a little bit embarrassed because you know you share this and all, but I like putting on a doll's wig and kiss him. You know, it's kind of like kissing a girl, which is really weird, but it's different.
Some people enjoy pretending. In the androgynous kiss, you pretend you're the opposite sex. Your kisses will feel totally different.
You know, when I spank my girlfriend because You kind of feel a shockwave, you know, run through her body. And, you know, if you're kissing her at the same time while you spank her, you get to feel like the shock and the kind of waves of energy going through her lips. It's just a hot thing. It's just real hot. And so enjoyable that it goes without saying.
Sometimes when I'm French kissing a boy, I like him to spank me a little bit. It livens up the makeout session.
Another thing that I really love that's a little bit embarrassing is while someone's kissing me, I love being spanked. And so even if it's just like a little tap, it's just a huge turn on for me.
The spanking kiss can be fun, but you must do it playfully. You must laugh while doing it. And remember, you're not trying to punish your partner. You're trying to make them have fun.
The way that I start is, you know, if you just kind of, to make him slow down a little bit, if you just kind of, you know, hold him at arm's length, kind of hold him by the arms like that, you know, and then grab him around the waist a little bit. And you want to be super slow. You want to just come in like this a little bit.
I wish someone could show me.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, I can show you, if you don't mind.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Okay, so you want to put this arm here and be really gentle. Come in real slow, and then just really gently with your lips, just kind of like that. That's perfect. Can you now move your head a little bit? That's very, very good. That's real nice. That's perfect. And if you start like that, you can have a little bit more control. You know, you can bring him in more when you want it.
Guys really like the hand kiss. They might not know it or admit it, but I like to give a guy a kiss on the hand or bite his fingers when I want to get him really excited, really get his attention.
It's mind-blowing. The feeling, the energy, the electricity that builds inside.
When she kisses my finger, I mean, it really just sends shockwaves through my body. It really just makes you feel utterly helpless, but in a very sensual way. It's just unbelievable.
Yeah, I just don't like the fact that we're around horses.
Well, Jen's finding out where there's some farms around here.
Okay, all right, let's get out
of here. Boy, I'm glad he's not riding in that car if he's stuffed in horse poop.
Guys, all I want you to think of before you get in the car, just go like this a few times.
I just stepped in it.
Oh, did you? So far,
I hate.
Mind the smell of horse
poop. Hate. Pull, Dan, pull. You're not doing anything. Pull the hair. Excellent. Now bite off each other's eyelashes. Each of you, try to get the other person's eyelashes. Chomp, Jessica. Chomp, chomp, chomp. The eyelash, chomp. Let's get a close-up just of the eyelash. Okay, keep doing the eyelash. Do it slower. We're going to get a very intense close-up. Dan, stand up straighter.
Sorry.
Dan, relax a little. Stand up straighter. Come on. Keep doing it, Jessica. Come on. We get this close up.
William Cain's books have been translated into 19 foreign languages. Well, he must be doing something right. A lot of people around the world want to read these books, and you should too. You'll become a better kisser by reading William Cain's books. The Art of Kissing is an international bestseller. It teaches you to do 30 different romantic kisses. How to French Kiss even contains diagrams showing how to move your tongue. The Art of Kissing Book of Questions and Answers is in question and answer format, perfect for teens. And The Art of Hugging will help you hug better. They'll love you after you read these books. Read them all and become a great kisser. Also available from kissing.com, the Art of Kissing how-to kiss videotape. Believe it or not, folks, we'll teach you how to attract boys to you, how to look at them, how to teach your boyfriend how to be a bad boy, instructing him where to stand so that you can enjoy your kisses with him more, how to flirt. You'll learn what to wear to attract boys to you. You'll learn how to position your feet, and we've got instructions for 30 different types of kisses. We go into a lot of details. We leave nothing untold. We'll teach you how to kiss the neck like your partners have never, ever been kissed before. I want you to see this tape, folks. You will not believe what's on it. We've got an actual, you will see an actual first kiss between two people who have never kissed before. You will learn 30 different kisses. Your boyfriend or girlfriend will say, "Where'd you learn to kiss like that?" We include instructions for the Trobriand Islands kiss, more stuff than you saw on the French kiss tape. Electric kiss, sliding music, vacuum kiss, 25 more. I hope you want to get this new tape, folks. If you do, it's called How to Kiss. You'll learn 30 different types of kisses. To order your copy, just go to our webpage, kissing.com. See you there.